Scuba diving. It always seemed like a good idea. Getting to explore the unknown underworld while meeting and greeting marine life. But now that big wave swept you away from your classmates, you're alone. And your oxygen is going down quickly. You take one last breath before you lose your oxygen source. The surface of the water is too far up. There's no way you can swim there in time. You can't hold your breath any longer. Water fills up your insides. So you get saved. What exactly happened when you technically drowned? Let's look at the stats. Every year, there are 370,000 deaths due to drowning, and children under 5 are at the most risk. Drowning has also been used as a method of execution for hundreds of years. So much so that in the 17th century, it was outlawed. It was brought back later for one spooky reason. Witches. Innocent women would be strapped to weights and tossed in the water. If they floated, they were witches and burned at the stake. If they drowned, well, then oops, our bad. To learn more on history like the Salem Witch Trials, subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. We've seen drowning on TV and movies, but like most things, drowning looks a lot different in real life. There's not really thrashing or yelling. It's actually pretty silent, which is why it's so easy to have happen. Something called a laryngospasm occurs, where your body blocks your airways to protect them from water. But that means you can't yell. But after a while, your body stops receiving oxygen and your organs relax, causing your lungs to fill up with H2O. It's also possible to go into cardiac arrest. The effects don't stop there. If you manage to get saved by a brave lifeguard, speaking of lifeguards, why do they always run in slow motion? People are dying. If you do manage to get saved, you may suffer brain damage if you were underwater for too long. There's also something called delayed drowning, where you can speak and breathe normally, but later in the day, your lungs will slowly fill up with water. If there's one takeaway here, it's that the body really needs oxygen, and drowning is a really easy thing to have happen. Consider this. In New Orleans in 1985, 200 people, half of them lifeguards, were celebrating a summer with zero drowning incidents. At that very party, a man drowned in the pool. Ugh, better always wear those floaties, no matter how good your swimming is. No one is above drowning. It can happen to anyone, no matter how good of a swimmer you are. We're looking at you, Michael Phelps. The best thing to avoid drowning, besides staying out of water, is to always play it safe. Never swim alone, wear a life vest on a boat, and don't get carried away playing games in the water. Even a breath-holding test could turn deadly. And don't ever think you're too cool for floaties. I think they're coming back in style.